Today we're going to talk about actinic keratoses, which are areas of the skin that look like this, that have been damaged by the sun. This video is going to help you understand what actinic keratoses are, what causes them, how they can be treated, plus where you can find more information about them. So first of all, what are actinic keratoses? Well, actinic keratoses, also known as solar keratoses, are areas of sun-damaged skin. They usually appear on parts of the body that are traditionally exposed to the sun, like the forearms, back of the hands, face, ears, and any scalp areas without hair, such as those affected by balding. However, they can also appear on the lips. Now, the terms actinic and solar both mean caused by sunlight, and keratosis simply means thickened skin. In terms of why they develop, actinic keratoses are caused by years of sun exposure. Now, this can include activities like sunbathing, using sunbeds, as well as working outdoors or enjoying outdoor recreational activities, plus living in sunny climates. Now, they're more common in older people and those with fair skin, blue eyes, and red or blonde hair, who typically burn easily in the sun. However, they can occur in anyone. Importantly, actinic keratoses are not contagious, meaning that they don't spread from one person to another. So now we know what they are and what causes them, well, what do they look and feel like? Well, actinic keratoses can vary in appearance. They might feel rough or scaly, similar to dry skin. They're often pink, but they can also be skin-coloured or red, and you might notice a change in the texture of your skin before seeing a colour change. In terms of size, they can grow to 1 to 2 centimetres in diameter, and sometimes they can develop a thicker, lumpy layer over them. The surrounding skin often looks sun-damaged, appearing blotchy, freckled, and wrinkled, and the other thing to mention is that there are usually several actinic keratoses in the same sun-exposed area. They rarely occur alone. Now, actinic keratoses often don't cause any problems, but can be itchy or sore. However, if they're left untreated for many years, there is a very small risk that an actinic keratosis can turn into a type of skin cancer called a squamous cell carcinoma. Now, people with many actinic keratoses are also at higher risk of developing other types of skin cancer compared to those without them. Now, it's important to be aware that if an actinic keratosis turns into a lump, it grows quickly, it becomes tender, forms an ulcer, or if it starts to bleed, it's important to seek medical advice. These changes could indicate early skin cancer, and people at higher risk of skin cancer include those with multiple actinic keratoses and those who are on immunosuppressive drugs such as organ transplant patients. So how are actinic keratoses diagnosed? Well, usually a doctor can diagnose them simply based on their appearance, i.e. they can just look at them. In cases of uncertainty, a small sample, known as biopsy of the skin, might be removed and examined under a microscope. In terms of how they're treated, well, they can be treated, but they tend to come back over time. Their presence indicates sun damage to the skin, so whilst an individual actinic keratoses can be cured, you might develop more in the future. Now, some actinic keratoses might go away without treatment, especially if they're small and if the skin is protected from the sun. Moisturisers can help with scaly patches. Now, there are several different treatment options that are available, and these can be discussed with your health professional. Now, the treatment will depend on the number as well as the location of the actinic keratoses and other individual factors as well. Now, some people might choose not to treat them and just to monitor their skin, but if you do decide to treat them, here are some of the options that are available to you. Now, the first option are creams, also known as topical treatments. Now, several types of cream or gel can be prescribed for those at home, including 5-fluorouracil, which you might know as Effudix. And I've made a separate, more detailed video on the channel specifically about this. Now, these treatments are effective, but they can cause temporary redness and soreness. So it's important to be aware of this as a potential side effect because it can be quite dramatic and people aren't often aware of this. Again, check out the other video on the channel where you can see real life photos of this. Now, another option is freezing with liquid nitrogen, also known as cryotherapy. Now, this treatment usually doesn't leave a scar, but may permanently lighten the treated area, but it can be slightly painful. Now, this will vary from person to person. Another option is surgical removal. This involves numbing the area with an injection and then scraping off the actinic keratoses with a sharp instrument or cutting it out with a blade and then closing the wound with stitches. Now, this leaves a scar, but it provides a sample that can then be examined to confirm the diagnosis if it's uncertain simply by the clinician looking at it. Now, the final two options that we'll briefly discuss are photodynamic therapy, where a special light is used to activate a medicated cream applied to the affected area, and also laser treatment. But these two are less common and they're only available in certain clinics. Now, like with many skin conditions, the key is prevention. Protecting your skin from the sun in the first place can help reduce the number of new actinic keratoses and lower the risk of developing skin cancer. And here are five things that I think that you should try following. First, wear protective clothing, including a hat that covers your face, neck, and ears, as well as UV protective sunglasses. Try avoid going out between 11 a.m. and 3 p.m. when it's most sunny and your skin is most likely to be damaged. Try also using a high protection sunscreen of at least SPF 30 with high UVA protection. I would apply this generously 15 to 30 minutes before you go outside and reapply it frequently. I'd also encourage you to do regular mole checks, so tell your doctor about any changes to a mole or patch of skin. If you're concerned about your skin, see a dermatologist, and also try look at your back, where you may not be able to see, but a family or friend member could do this. Try avoiding sunbeds, so stay away from artificial sun lamps, including sunbeds and UV tanning cabinets. For more detailed information on actinic keratoses, please check out the description box of this video, and thanks for watching.